Hi, I'm Dara Huizen from PLR Planners, and I'm going to show you how to use the desktop wallpaper templates that we've got in our store. So first of all, to clarify, what you're seeing at the moment on my computer screen is a desktop wallpaper that I've set up. Now, I'm going to have three screens, and I'll show you how you set them up for each one. But what you would basically do is you would go in and you would select one of the images that you've created and make it a desktop. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you. I'm going to quickly open up. There are my desktops. I know that slide 7 is for July, so I'm going to select the image, and I'm going to right-click it, and I'm going to say Set as Desktop Background. Now, if I minimize that, you can see that my desktop image has changed. Now, if you've got different screens, like in the case where I've got three different screens, you may need to go into your settings, and I'll bring that up now. I'm going to drag that across, and I'm going to go into personalization. And over here, you've got the option to set for monitor 1, monitor 2, and monitor 3. You would do that if your screens are different ratios. And in my case, they definitely are. I've got a wide screen on the one, I've got a laptop screen, and then I've got this one. But for the purposes of this exercise, I'm just going to leave it as it is. But you would have to set it up for the different screens, because otherwise it's completely distorted. Okay, so that's how you would do it, first of all. So now, your desktop. And the whole purpose of this is to make life a little bit easier. So let's say we've got folders and we've got tools. So I'm going to bring across all the tools that I would use on a normal basis and pop that there. And I need one for my A member login, so we'll pop that there. And what it's doing is it's allowing you to get your screen sorted out and cleaned up and tidy. So we'll bring in Filmora. And what else can we bring? So basically, you can do whatever you like. If you've got a messy desktop like mine, which I'm not showing you, I'm just showing you my one screen, you can set it up in such a way that you can have it on multiple screens so that you've got work on different areas. So let's just see. Let's say we'll bring in some folders. PowerPoint replicator we'll put over there. My Cassie's file over there. And whatever else you want. So you're basically just going to set this all up so that you can find things based on your desktop wallpaper or calendar at the back. And you can do the same with an image that's just been created. Let me show you some more. If I go back to the desktop product idea and I pick up that one and I make that the desktop, and I minimize it. Now you can see that's over there. You can see this one's distorted because it's not the right size for the screen. If we open it up again, let's go for set that one up, minimize it. You can see over there now that's my desktop. So this is what desktop calendars or wallpapers are for. It's for you to play around and make your screens look pretty, or more specifically, for your customers to play around and make their screens look pretty. Let's see if I can find you one of these that I did. Now you can see that's one of the junk journal ones that I created. It's slightly out of proportion, but what you would do in this case is the customers could drag their icons onto that little piece of paper. So we'll do that. So basically, it's just a way for somebody to have a pretty desktop and at the same time have all their icons organized in a way that they can find stuff. So that's the first part of it. Now, the second part of it is I'm going to show you how I actually use the templates that we've created. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you how to create one of these desktop wallpapers for yourself. I have opened up one of the four documents that we've supplied in our desktop wallpaper templates. We've got the four different ratios. There's 4x3, 5x4, 16x9, and 16x10. Now, within each document, we have got 10 different layouts that we've set up for you to use, okay? And we've done them as master slides. So if you go to view and slide master, you will see that each of the different layouts are there. And the reason for this blank space in the middle is because I am using these to generate the calendar. So if I close the view, you'll see here I've got a table here that I'm going to use to generate the calendar using my calendar generator that was developed by Hans and myself. So let's decide, first of all, what layout we want. So if we have a look here, I quite like this layout. So this is layout number 5. So I'm going to save this document as another name and then start playing with it. So I will delete everything else up to slide 5. I'll just delete it and then we'll just have that one there and that. Okay. Now remember, you have to do it for all 4 sizes that you've got. So you have to remember what you're doing. So the first thing I'm going to do is I actually want to edit this ever so slightly. So I'm going to go to View, Slide Master, and I'm actually going to get rid of one of these and just pull this up to here. All right. And then what I'd like to do is probably have a little bit of an image. Now you can play around with the different colors. So if I go back to the main view and I go down to Design and I go to Colors, I can pick different colors. Let's say we'll take a vintage test. And then if I go back to the Slide Master, I decide I actually want this one to be a different color. So I'm going to format the shape and I'm going to pick a fill. So let's say we go for a pale green, maybe that one to be a bit different. This one I want to have as maybe a paler green. And maybe what I'd like to do over here is have a motivational quote. So I'll go and quickly copy a motivational quote. So I'm going to insert a text box over here. Now you can either do it as in the master slide, or alternatively you can actually do it in the main file itself. But we're just doing it here. We'll leave that there and I'm going to center that and maybe just have it down at the bottom. And then what I might do is bring in a picture. Let's bring in that. Okay, and then over here what I might do is I want to have, I'm going to copy that. And I'll put this over here and I'm going to say this is going to be icons for work and control C, control V and take it down there to say social media. All right, so I'm just creating blocks for people to go and put their icons in and you can change the sizes around and everything. I'll just move that up. Okay, and now I'm ready, so I'm going to close the master view. And there it is there. All right, now this calendar section over here, you can change, you can keep the same colors, or alternatively you can leave it as a blank, because what you could do is you could go in and you could insert a background image. So if I go in and let's say I want to insert a background color, I'll go back to the Slide Master and I will make shape and I'll send that to the back in a minute. So shape format, send to back, and let's change the color of that to maybe a very pale green. Okay, now if I go back to the normal view, it's brought that across. So let's put a shadow on this table. I'll leave it as a colored pink table for now, but I'm going to do a table design. I'm going to give it a slight shadow, all right, and then I'm going to insert a text box. Change the size of that a bit. And I'm going to put in my parameters for my calendar generator. Okay, so now my document is ready. So I'm going to save it as a new file and I'll call it Diana Video Purposes. All right. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up my PowerPoint replicator, and inside the PowerPoint replicator is the calendar creator. Now this is what our calendar creator looks like. You don't have to use this. You can have other, you can find other options or do it manually yourself. I want to do a monthly one. I want it to start on Monday. I want it to start on the 1st of July. I want it to be months. And I want to have a short day format over there. All right. So we selected that it's going to start on Monday. It's monthly. There's my file name parameter. So it's given it to me there. I'm going to select the PowerPoint file. There's my file there. So I'm going to select it. I'm going to verify it. Tells me that there are no unknown variables found. And so what I'll do is I'll generate the calendar. I'll open it up again. And now you can see over here that I've got each month, July, August, September. But I don't like this because this is too big and these are not fitting nicely. So I'm going to go and change this slightly. I'm going to go back to the original. And I'm going to first of all change that text to a better color that fits in. So let's make it go for one of those dark ones there. And then what you can do is, with obviously with our calendar generator, is you can format the font and what you want in it. I'm going to make this a whole lot smaller. I'm going to make it go for the dark. And I think what I might do is actually get rid of all of the shading on this, with the exception of that. So let's say we get rid of that. We'll say no shading. And I don't want any borders around that. Okay, so that's what it looks like at the moment. So I'll click on save. And then I'll run it again. Okay, now you can see that that looks a little bit better in terms of the formatting of the font and things like that. So this is the general idea. You just play around with it. You can obviously set up these images that you don't have, let's say, this picture in the master slides, but you can change the image using either manually or you can use Picture Me Perfect, the plugin that we have on our website. Basically, you're unlimited in terms of what you can create. You can modify these as much as you like. You can bring in different elements. And as I've shown you from some of the examples, you can literally create hundreds and hundreds of different products using these templates that are completely different, and you can sell them to people either on Etsy or on your own website. So I hope that's clarified things for you. Let me know if you've got any questions.